Hi, I'm Emily Audibert from Woolcott, Connecticut.
So let's go to a beauty product that you cannot live without.
I would have to say I can't live without my mascara because that's really all I wear unless I'm competing. I'm not really the whole, let's put on a whole face full of makeup, so mascara all the way.
There we go. And who in your life has taught you the most about makeup or beauty? And what's the biggest thing, advice that they gave you?
Well, I would have to say from my mom. We don't really wear a lot of makeup, my family and my friends. We're not really all about that. So what my mom has taught me is that beauty is from within and to smile really, really big wherever you go, whenever you meet people, and then they'll like you. So it's not about your makeup, but it's about your smile and what you give to them.
There we go.
Yeah.
Smile.
See?
There it is.
Really big teeth, so it's okay.
Exactly. I mean, since smile's important, like, do you use any teeth whiteners, or what's your secret to getting that smile perfect?
I did. I had braces for a long time. That was embarrassing. And then I used teeth whitener after I got my braces off for about 2 years, and then my teeth started hurt really, really badly, so I stopped. So I haven't done them since, and they just kind of stayed this way. I think they don't look as white as other people, but I think because they're so large that they look very white.
Yeah, you got a good smile.
Thank you.
They are white. Now, as far as eating and everything, what's something that you're just dying to get your hands on that you've been avoiding this whole time?
That I've been avoiding. So my favorite food are homemade cookies, and my guilty pleasure is a hot dog. It's disgusting, I know. My platform is Let's Move, Fight Against Childhood Obesity, and I love hot dogs. It's terrible. So I would have to say cookies and hot dogs. I don't think I'll eat the hot dog till the summer, though.
Okay. What do you put on the hot dog?
Just ketchup and mustard.
Plain Jane hot dog.
Plain Jane hot dog, yeah.
There we go, all right. Now let's go back to your first memory of this pageant. Like, whether you were 8 years old, 10, or whatever, what do you first remember about Miss America?
Well, this is actually my first time being involved in the pageant since I was younger. When I was younger, it would have to be my dance teacher, Amy Zapone Brooks. She was my dance teacher and she became Miss Woolcott. And then that same year, she won Miss Connecticut, and then she went on to be Miss America. And she was my dance teacher throughout my entire life, and I thought she was God's gift to this earth. And I still do, actually. So she's really what motivated me to becoming in this pageant. And she would have to be my real memory that I associate with the Miss America organization.
There we go. Good answer. Awesome. Nice talking to you.
Thank you.
Okay, Emily, how long did it take you to pick out your evening gown for the evening gown competition?
About 20 minutes.
20 minutes? What, did you just try on one dress and you loved it so much?
Yes.
No way.
Yes, I just took an idea from that and another one that I just looked at. I don't really like trying things on.
So did you have the dress made?
Yes.
What color is it? What do you like about it? What can you tell us as a sneak peek?
Oh, I can tell you all about it. That's fine. It's a black velvet, and it just goes all the way down. It's very simple. It's sophisticated. It reminds me of Audrey Hepburn. So...